14 of the world's 20 most polluted cities are in India, finds the World Health Organization. What's the plan to combat this national health emergency? Chota Rajan is held guilty of murdering veteran investigative journalist Jay Day. On World Press Freedom Day, we look at why India is ranked a dismal 138 in the Press Freedom Index. And Facebook is set to play Cupid, even as privacy concerns loom in the background. It's Thursday, May 3rd. On May 30th, 2011, veteran crime journalist Jyotirmoy Day wrote this article, detailing what he described as desperate attempts by the aging gangster Chota Rajan. On June 2nd, 2011, Day wrote about how Rajan's men were going underground, fearing a backlash from Dawood's brother, Iqbal Khaskar. 9 days later, Day was gunned down in broad daylight. It was alleged then by Chota Rajan's men on a motorcycle at Hiranandani Pavai. The charge sheet said Rajan had ordered the killing, annoyed by his portrayal as a small-time crook, in a book the journalist was planning to write. Entitled Chindi, Rags to Riches, the book was meant to be a compilation of the stories of 20 gangsters. On Wednesday, a special Makoka court held Rajan guilty. Former journalist Jigna Vora, who the police had alleged instigated Rajan because of professional jealousy, was acquitted by the court. Incidentally, today is World Press Freedom Day. According to the recently released World Press Freedom Index, which measures the level of press freedom in 180 countries, India has dropped to a dismal 138. The report details that self-censorship is growing in mainstream media and journalists are increasingly the targets of online smear campaigns by the most radical nationalists who vilify them, even threaten physical reprisals.
Supreme Court order.
51-year-old assistant town planner Shail Bala Sharma, seen here conveying that she's here to implement a Supreme Court order against unauthorized constructions in 13 hotels in Kasauli, was shot dead minutes later by this man, Vijay Thakur, owner of the Narayani guest house, one of the violators. Despite the presence of police and other government officials, Singh managed to flee. The Supreme Court pulled up the Himachal Pradesh government when it tried to defend itself amid allegations that the officer was not provided adequate police protection. The bench had some strong words for the state government, saying, "We might stop passing any order if you're going to kill people." Last month, while ordering the demolition of illegal structures in the hills, the apex court had held that not only was this an environmental hazard, but also endangered lives. The court noted that the illegal construction had put the entire city in danger, causing landslides. "14 of the world's 20 most polluted cities are in India in terms of PM2.5 levels. This is as per the latest World Health Organization report. Kanpur tops the list and is followed by these cities. PM2.5 is fine particulate matter, about 30 times finer than a human hair. These particles can be inhaled deep into the lungs, causing heart attacks, strokes, lung cancer, and respiratory diseases. In the list of mega cities with a population of 14 million or more, Delhi tops the list of most polluted. Mumbai is at number 4, coming in before Beijing at number 5. The WHO data says 9 out of 10 people in the world breathe air containing high levels of pollutants. There are two types of pollutions, ambient air that alone caused some 4.2 million deaths in 2016, and household air pollution from cooking with polluting fuels and technologies caused an estimated 3.8 million deaths. The Director General of the WHO said it is unacceptable that over 3 billion people, most of them women and children, are still breathing deadly smoke every day from using polluting stoves and fuels in their homes. The report notes India's Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana scheme is an example of measures taken to tackle this, saying it provided some 37 million women living below the poverty line with free LPG connections to support them to switch to clean household energy use. India targets to reach 80 million households by 2020. So, what's the government doing to deal with this national health emergency? A national clean air program draft has been created. The draft identifies 100 cities as non-attainment cities, which is those cities that have not met the laid-down national ambient air quality standard. It would look at the various sources of pollution in these cities and target each of these sources. It seeks to create city-specific air action plans. The plan provides for funding, capacity building, and source apportionment studies. Once the plan is ready, city and state administrations will have to ensure that targets are met.
So today, we are announcing a new set of features coming soon around dating.
Oh yes, Facebook is going the Tinder way. It wants to help 200 million people who list themselves as single find
meaningful relationships.
The apparent theme of Facebook CEO Mark Zuckerberg's F8 developer conference, and what he hopes will salvage the social media company from their recent privacy storm. It's the same promises. Meaningful conversations, people with similar interests, and a possible happily ever after.
This is going to be for building real long-term relationships, all right? Not just hookups.
So, the people you will be matched with won't be from your friend list. Friends can't see your dating profiles, and the dating feature, which will be part of Messenger, won't infringe on your privacy. But how is this the next step in the online chess of love? It does eliminate the step where you Facebook someone you met on Tinder and get better acquainted through Messenger. It presumably also has more data on you as compared to most other dating apps which rely on you logging in through Facebook for data. But apart from that, it's still connecting you to strangers, not the people you're interested in or those you stalk on Facebook. So, what's the point? Investors are confident though. Tinder's parent company Match Group stocks fell some 22% after the announcement. So, what's next? Meet someone on Facebook, chat through Messenger, announce engagement, marriage, babies through Instagram, and keep in touch through a WhatsApp family group? What a happy Zuckerberg family, right? See you tomorrow.